Hello, everybody. Tegan here with High Point. We thank you so much for tuning in, as always. Today's video is all about the Apatura Lithium Power Supply. This is an excellent way to power all of your astronomy gear out in the field, so stay tuned. Let's get started. Okay, so as with all of our product review videos, we're gonna start with an unboxing session, then we're gonna talk about the ports, the accessories, and everything that the Apatura Lithium Power Supply has to offer, and then we're going to get into the meat and potatoes of the video, where we test the longevity of the battery life of the power supply using different types of equipment. We're talking visual setups, full astrophotography setups, portable setups. You're not gonna wanna miss it. Let's unbox. When you open the box, the first thing you'll see is a nice set of instructions. Underneath the foam casing is an additional box that houses several adapters. And by several, we mean three male to female adapters, a male to male power adapter, and a charging cable. Lastly, you will find the Apatura Lithium power supply itself. Now that we have the unboxing finished, let's look at all the ports and the accessories and everything that the Apatura Lithium Power Supply has to offer. On the front of the Apatura Power Supply, you have two LED lights, one to show you that the AC output is enabled and the other to show you remaining battery life. On the back, you have the three-prong AC output plug, which can power a power strip if you have multiple devices. Turn the power tank 180 degrees and you will see that it comes equipped with a red flashlight and a DC input for charging the device itself. Whip the power supply back around 180 degrees and below the AC input are three powered USB ports and three 12 volt output ports for powering nearly any kind of equipment. Finally, on the bottom of the power tank are exact specifications for all output ports on the device. All right, now it is time to test the longevity of our fully charged battery on a visual setup, the Celestron Nexstar 8SE. I'll be going out to slew to a different target every 20 or 30 minutes just to mimic a real life viewing experience. Let's set it up. All right, so testing the longevity of the battery with the 8SE definitely showed that the power supply can last all night long if you're doing something as simple as visual astronomy. I wasn't using a dew heater, I wasn't using a laptop, I was just powering the Nexstar 8SE with an eyepiece. If that's the kind of experience that you want to have out in the middle of nowhere while you're camping, this power supply is going to last a very long time. I was impressed. So for tonight's test, our second test, I'm going to be powering the Skywatcher Star Adventure GTI that I have set up over here on my right. On top of it is the Great Apatura 60 EDR doublet, and it's all sitting on the Apatura carbon fiber photographic tripod. So the GTI is the only thing that I'm going to be connecting to the Apatura lithium power supply. I'm not going to be powering a laptop or a dedicated astronomy camera or anything like that. I want to see how long the GTI can last on a full battery. And also, a link to both the Apatura tripod and the 60 EDR you can find in the description. Let's get started. No. Now, this test was made to simulate a portable astrophotography setup, something that you may take out camping with you or under dark skies in the desert or maybe to the mountains. That being said, a fully charged lithium power supply is going to last you a very long time, especially if the only thing you are powering is your mount or a sky tracker like the SkyWatcher GTI. After nearly 11 hours of standard sidereal tracking with the GTI, the LED lights still showed 100% battery on the Apertura power supply. Now pair this with a DSLR and a lens, now you have an entire weekend of shooting either Milky Way photos or deep sky astro photos. All right, so with all of that being said, it is time to move on to part one of our last test. Let's go check it out. Alright, so the great thing about tonight's test is that I already have my imaging rig just set up and ready to go. It's pretty much set up on any given night, ready and waiting for a clear sky. I'm going to be using the DC power adapters to power the mount and the camera tonight through the Apertura power supply. I will be powering my laptop through an extension cable that goes directly to my house. The goal tonight is to get a full narrowband data set on the Tadpole Nebula, which hits about 30 degrees at about 9 o'clock p.m., if not a little bit earlier, so I should be able to start imaging around that time. Hopefully, we can get a pretty cool image out of it. All right, so now that we finished part one of our last test, it is time to move on to part two. So tonight's test is going to be nearly identical to last night's test. The only difference is that last night I powered my laptop through an extension cable going directly to my house. But tonight I'm going to be powering my mount, my camera, and my laptop through the Apertura lithium power supply. So I'm going to be running my full imaging rig through the power supply. Now, I think the laptop is going to be the piece of equipment responsible for drawing the most power away from the battery life. That all being said, I still plan on shooting a full narrowband data set tonight of the Tadpole Nebula. Let's get to it. Now that concludes our last test, and the results were interesting, but not shocking. With the Apertura power supply, I was able to power the mount, the cooled camera, and the laptop for a total of 3.5 hours. Now what's interesting is how much battery power was actually used up by the laptop, because when I just powered the mount and the camera alone using the Apertura power supply and powering the laptop through an extension cable from my house, I was able to image from 6:45 p.m. all the way to 2:30 a.m. Now that is a little over 8 hours, so it just shows you that if you have a different method of powering your laptop, definitely use it if you want to get all of the data that you possibly can that night. You may save even more battery using something like the ASI Air Plus or a Prima Luce Lab onboard computer. Okay, so that is it for our video tonight. If you've stayed with us, we thank you so much for tuning in tonight. And if you have any questions, please let us know in the comments below, and we're always happy to assist you. Again, please remember to like, subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss any future content. Thank you again, and clear skies.